every night, I dream the same dream.
El hechicero más importante de Marvel está de vuelta con esta segunda entrega que tiene expectantes a todos sus fans. Doctor Strange en el multiverso de la locura promete múltiples viajes y aventuras en distintas dimensiones que nos relatarán qué es lo que sigue para Stephen Strange y Wanda, la conflictuada y a la vez querida Bruja Escarlata que nos conquistó en WandaVision. Conversamos entonces con Benedict Cumberbatch, quien nos contó cómo se siente encarnar a este aclamado personaje.
I'm sorry, Stephen. Your desecration of reality will not go unpunished.
Benedict, this is the sixth time you role Doctor Strange. So, what do you feel about this character, and what do you think about his evolution all across these movies?
Recently, I think a thing on my mind until this film of going, gosh, he really is becoming kind of omnipotent and all-knowing, and I think this film is a slight testing of where he's at. And yeah, of course, we know that evolution in the origin story from neurosurgeon to superhero and the sort of personal sacrifice of that, doing good for others rather than his own ego and career. But I think he's still driven by the same ingredients of ego. So yeah, there's a lot that he goes through, and there's a more singular focus being a standalone film, although it is a crowded piece, this film. We are dealing with the multiverse and new characters, America Chavez, which I'm sure we'll talk about, and Wanda, as well as returning characters that people know and love, like Wong and Mordo and Christine Palmer. So yeah, it's there. It's definitely the next step for him, and a springboard for where he goes next as well, which I'm very excited for people to get an idea of by the end of the film.
What is the most challenging thing for you to role this character? Because I find it like very physical. Not as physical as your Bagheera from the Book of the Jungle, but still. So what is this the most challenging thing for you?
I guess so. I'm a few years older than I was during the first movie, so I feel it a bit more. But you know, it's one of the joys of doing this. You kind of have your health cared for, and it's hard work, but it's really good fun. You're working out, you're rehearsing stunts, you have great choreographers, you have a fantastic team helping put back your body back together should you be banged up in a fight scene, or a bit of, you know, wire rigging and stunt work that can be, you know, quite grueling. But I think the hardest thing really, let alone the action, is just the hours. That it's a very long shoot. But there's downtime, it's piecemeal, they're very intense moments, and then, you know, hours whilst you wait for a complex setup to happen. So in a way, it's more about pacing yourself. It's the kind of marathon nature of it, really. That's the big challenge, I'd say. And keeping creative and fresh within that space.
Let's suppose for a minute that you are not rolling Doctor Strange.
Yep.
Who other character from Marvel would you like to roll, and why?
Thanos? I don't know. I know. I'm just saying the first thing that comes into my head because there's a friend in the room. I don't know. Look, I'm really happy with who I am, and I think there's a lot of who I am in this film. So I'm gonna stick with the guy I've got and sort of dodge that question.
Bye, Benedict. Bye, very Steph. Nice to meet you.
Lovely to meet you too.
Things just got out of hand.